There was once a land where the weather was very, very strange. There were awful heat waves in some parts, and in others, terrible storms and floods.
We've heard a lot about extreme events in recent years.
Storms are becoming more intense. Summer in March heat wave, record wildfires across the West, the biggest drought in living memory, the biggest storm we've ever measured.
It's going to be climate chaos.
We will be seeing a change in the frequency, intensity, and geographical distribution of things like heat waves, droughts, and floods.
According to some climate predictions, as our planet warms due to accumulating greenhouse gases, the number and intensity of extreme weather events will increase. Some believe it's already happening, and that the heat waves and storms we've seen recently are occurring more often. So what's the evidence? Is extreme weather becoming the new normal? Is global warming to blame?
And as a scientist and a mother of two teenagers, I'd like to tell you about the top five things that keep me awake at night.
According to some scientists, like Professor Jennifer Francis of Rutgers University, it's already happening, and that there is a recent increase in the number and severity of extreme weather events.
I think what we're seeing happening just in these last few years are completely consistent with what we should expect to see happening more often as we go forward in time. And we've just been doing actually some research with projections of the future using climate models, looking at this very topic of the frequency of heat waves, the tendency for them to occur in certain places. And what we're seeing is by the end of this century that indeed they should become more intense and more frequent, especially in the western part of our country and in Eastern Europe and Western Russia, that region there. So the fact that we've seen this occurring more often just in the last decade or so seems to be very consistent with what the models are projecting for the end of the century.
But there are other views. Dr. Roger Pilkey Jr. of the University of Colorado says there hasn't been a recent change in extreme weather events.
A few weeks ago, I testified before the U.S. Senate on this topic. And there I presented data that showed that specifically in the United States, but also globally, there are no upwards trends in the number of tropical cyclones, of which hurricanes are a subset, drought in the United States or globally, floods, again, in the United States or globally, or tornadoes. There is some data that suggests there's been a greater incidence of heat waves over the last 30 years in particular. And then there's also a category that's called extreme precipitation, for which there have been trends documented, but you have to be very careful because extreme precipitation is not the same thing as flooding. There's a lot of reasons why, but one reason is that what scientists define as extreme often is not at a threshold that leads to high stream flow.
So your view that there is no evidence for an increase in hurricanes, in cyclones, and that. Is that a consensus view? How much debate is there about this?
Yeah, well, actually, the science of extreme events and trends is among the least complicated you'll find in climate science because phenomena like hurricanes are big. You don't miss them when they occur, and they're rare events, so there's not a lot to count. And the fact that there is not an increase in hurricanes or tornadoes or floods or drought is not really controversial in the scientific community. In fact, the IPCC, Intergovernmental Panel on Climate Change, concluded the exact same thing in its 2012 special report on extreme events.
Well, you're right. There are different views on that. The problem is that before we had satellite information, it was difficult to know for sure whether we had records of all the hurricanes that actually occurred, because unless it hit a ship or, you know, there was somebody there to measure it before a satellite could see it, then it might have gone undetected. It was also much harder to determine how intense they were. So before 1979, you know, maybe mid-70s, we really don't have as good records, but there have been some recent studies looking at the latter part of the satellite record, comparing it to the earlier part, and it does seem as though the strongest types of hurricanes, the category fours and fives, have been increasing, whereas the weaker ones perhaps not.
So what's going on? Are strong hurricanes on the increase? In 2012, the Intergovernmental Panel on Climate Change issued its report on extreme weather events and concluded that apart from warmer days and increased extreme precipitation, there's no evidence of hurricanes, storms, tornadoes and floods occurring more frequently. What's more, Dr. Pilkey Jr. believes that it would take a long time to gather the data to tell if these extreme events are changing.
The scientific community, and by that I mean, you know, the mainstream IPCC reports, project that there will be more frequent and more intense extreme events in the future. We did a study, it was led by Ryan Crompton at Macquarie University in Sydney, where we took recent climate model projections for changes in intense hurricanes. There was something like an 80 to 90% increase in the incidence of Category 5 and Category 4 hurricanes in the United States by 2080, something like a 1% change per year. So we took that as basically the truth. And we said, let's assume the world evolves in this way. When would we be able to detect that change in the we were interested in the statistics of damage, but you could also ask when would you see that in the statistics of hurricanes? And it turns out, starting with that assumption of these very large changes, it's going to be many decades, maybe centuries, before we actually can detect, according to the IPCC definition of detection, a change in the statistics of these events. The main reason for this is that they are extreme events. They're rare. They don't happen a lot. So it's a little bit like playing poker and someone puts another ace into the deck. You have to play an awful lot of hands before you have some sense that the deck has been stacked. What that means is that there's actually no scientific reason to expect, this is with respect to hurricanes, that we would be able to detect a signal today, even assuming the effects that are projected going forward. To the extent that the statistics of other extreme events like floods and drought are similar to hurricanes, you're going to get very similar results. So the long story short is that we really shouldn't expect to see these signals for many decades going forward.
So according to some studies, we don't have enough evidence to say that the warming of our planet in the 20th century has caused any significant change in extreme weather events other than warmer days and increased extreme downpours.
A way forward on this debate was to focus on the things that have meaning to people in their immediate context. And extreme weather, which would seem to have a relationship to broader climate change, is the hook that's been chosen.
Across the globe, cataclysmic weather events are occurring with such regularity that it's being called a new normal. But there's nothing normal about it. Dirty energy has created a world of dirty weather.
Extreme weather has always really been part of the debate, at least for the last 20, 25 years. But there's been a much more explicit effort to try to connect Hurricane Sandy or Katrina or the drought of the U.S. or the hot summer in Europe, or, you know, pick your event and say this is the sort of event we expect. And there's some clever language that goes along with that. Sometimes people say this is consistent with what we would expect, which is a meaningless statement, or they say this is the sort of event we will have more of in the future, or they go even further out on a limb and say this event was caused, influenced, impacted in some way by greenhouse gas emissions. It's a very slippery slope to go down when the data is against you, and I'm not sure how long this particular approach will be in the debate, because I don't think it's sustainable, but it's with us now and a lot of attention is being paid to it.
But it seems that many are accepting speculation as fact, assuming that extreme events are more common and linked to global warming, despite what the science says.
And look at the devastation we've had with only a 1 degree increase, with the Arctic ice cap melting, the jet stream meandering, the droughts and floods and escalating strong storms. This is something that we really have to face up to.
And like Al Gore, EU Climate Commissioner Connie Hedegaard claims that science leads policies.
Politics will have to be inspired from what we know, will be based on the science.
But after saying that the politics must follow the science, she admits there's little evidence for an increase in climate extremes, before claiming that there is an increase, contradicting herself and the IPCC.
I recognise, of course, that most scientists say that it's difficult to establish whether a particular event is actually linked to climate change. It's very difficult to establish that until years later. That is in the nature of natural science. But the overall pattern of events seems already to be bearing out the forecast that climate change will bring more frequent and more severe extreme weather.
People are noticing that the weather patterns are changing. They're hearing scientists say more and more that there are these connections between climate change and these extreme weather events that they're experiencing. They can see with their very own eyes that the Arctic sea ice has diminished by approximately half in terms of square area. So all these things are so conspicuous and so obvious to anybody who thinks about it for even half a second that I think people are really starting to pay attention. The media are paying attention. Even politicians are paying attention. So I think we're maybe going to see some action now.
It's true that no single event makes a trend. But the fact is, the 12 hottest years on record have all come in the last 50. Heat waves, droughts, wildfires, floods, all are now more frequent and more intense. We can choose to believe that Superstorm Sandy and the most severe drought in decades and the worst wildfires some states have ever seen were all just a freak coincidence. Or we can choose to believe in the overwhelming judgment of science and act before it's too late.
Well, you know, politicians say all sorts of things, and it's not just climate change. And on that instance, President Obama was simply incorrect. I think, you know, my view is fairly laid back in terms of politicians saying things. I think it's something altogether different when experts or even campaigners who are arguing on the authority of science say things that are misleading or incorrect. More troubling than President Obama kind of getting forward on his skis with his extreme event statement is the absolute and complete silence among my colleagues in the scientific community, who are normally quite quick to correct or amend or clarify statements that are made in this debate. It seems that there's a double standard here, that if President Obama says something that's incorrect, he gets a free pass. But if, say, Senator James Inhofe says something that's incorrect, he gets roundly criticized.
With the global temperature of the Earth's land and ocean surface showing no rise in over 16 years, it seems that some are turning to extreme weather events as a more obvious manifestation of global warming. The problem is that despite many treating it as a well-established fact, there is presently no definite evidence for it.
Immediately and observe safety precautions.
We're in danger of letting the politics of extreme weather events lead the science and letting policies reflect impressions and not evidence.
Is there a happy ending?